From aircraft to spacecraft, the aeronautics industry is embracing digital tools to improve quality and efficiency. But how is this industry, known for long product lead times and manufacturing backlogs, embracing digital operations to transform workflows, increase efficiency, and quicken development? And how are they utilizing augmented reality and virtual reality technology? Find out now in this episode of Mechanical Engineering Magazine's Special Report. NASA's Artemis program plans to return humans to the moon as well as take them deeper into space than ever before. NASA contractors such as Lockheed Martin are using digital systems in designing and building the Orion spacecraft for these missions. Lockheed Martin uses augmented reality to increase efficiency on the manufacturing floor. The firm began using the technology in 2017. And found it speeds the time needed to perform complex tasks, such as wiring. Workers use HoloLens goggles to see exactly where to place a component, its orientation, and reference number. Instructions are overlaid in 3D onto the physical portion of the spacecraft being assembled. Technicians reported time to completion for some tasks fell from multiple shifts to just one. The firm used AR on critical components, including the crew module and heat shield. Supervisors report crews used AR across 4 sites and completed manufacturing tasks in 90% less time than traditional methods. Lockheed Martin has embraced the digital world, including building a large virtual reality laboratory for collaboration between product design and manufacturing teams involved in space, including satellites or solar array projects. It's also been used on the F-15 and F-22 programs and is being used across the company. Major aircraft manufacturers are also embracing digital. Airbus is 7 years into its digital transformation. They are also using digital twins and AR in its A320 family of aircraft, helicopters, and various other programs. They use a digital platform to integrate all of the company's data for employees and customers. The Airbus 350 has some 4 million parts, with more than 250,000 sensors generating more than 10 gigabytes of data per flight hour. Gathering and analyzing that data results in more efficient maintenance and less downtime. Around 100 airlines are operating within Airbus's digital platform, with the goal to connect large aviation firms in an end-to-end system. Company executives report Airbus engineers build 4 digital twins for each new aircraft, one for the product, and one each for related production equipment, production process, and service process, simulating all aspects before building the product significantly reduces production costs and engineering lifecycle. In Hamburg, the firm has built Airbus Innovation Center using virtual reality drawn from film, the gaming industry, and its own software engineers. Using 3D, it allows Airbus to design a customer's cabin specifications and then view and interact with the design. Engineers can use a standard aircraft beverage cart and wheel it through the virtual cabin, looking for impediments or flow obstacles. The customer can see the final product in the beginning of the workflow. Virtual and augmented reality require a considerable amount of computing power, which is simply too much of a load for server-based systems. And with utilization of this breakthrough technology ramping up, focus needs to shift to a solution. More emphasis is now being put on cloud computing, which will be bolstered by the coming 5G deployment. 5G will strengthen mobile connections between VR headsets and their companion computers. It will improve latency, and increase the amount of data a system can process. Displays will also improve along with mobility within a virtual environment. Collaboration will become even easier. Boeing, the world's largest aircraft manufacturer, is going all in on a digital makeover. It is moving to design its aircraft in the metaverse, which is a shared interactive virtual environment. It plans to rework its entire engineering and manufacturing operations in 2 years, using digital twins to work with robots that speak to each other, while engineers and technicians use AR goggles to adjust, fix, and maintain components on the factory floor or in the field. Building off its successful TR-7 trainer project for the U.S. Air Force, Boeing last year announced a complete engineering and manufacturing digital conversion. In making the announcement, Greg Hislop, Boeing's chief engineer, said it is about strengthening engineering and changing the way we work across the entire company. According to Hislop, more than 70% of quality issues harken back to a design issue. Boeing believes digital tools can perhaps halve the amount of time it takes a new aircraft to come to market, from 10 years to 5 years or even 4. The company first uses digital tools on the 767 tanker, producing 3D images of wiring bundles and fitting out mechanics with HoloLens AR headsets and tablets. Reports say that quality improved 90%. It expanded into digital design with the Air Force T-7A trainer, bringing it to market in 36 months. The Air Force was impressed, making its own commitment to digital design in the development and testing of weapons systems. The Air Force Research Laboratory's Munitions Directorate is now using a virtual coliseum, where vendors can use a digital twin of a proposed weapons platform in a virtual evaluation. The program, called Golden Horde, is to demonstrate networked collaborative and autonomous weapons by creating an integrated weapons system where weapons work autonomously together. Working with Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory, the virtual test center has already hosted air combat simulations in a digital version of the real world. The next step is to design for collaborative weapons. The goal is to design a complex system that is still available to as many competitors and their own technology as possible. These innovations are setting the stage for the next step in the evolution of aerospace design and manufacturing.